everyone, and welcome to a very massive book unhaul. I like to do a book unhaul about 2 times a year to keep my book collection organized, to get rid of some books that I don't necessarily like all that much, but also to make more space on my bookshelves. And the latter was definitely the case with this book unhaul because I really don't have space on my shelves left anymore, so I had to get rid of some books. So yeah, that's what I'm going to do today. I'm going to get rid of some books and I'm going to show you which ones I don't want anymore. And as always, I will make sure that all the books that I get rid of will get a new home. I will either give them to friends or like try to sell them or give them to charity shops. So don't worry, these books will all go to a new place and then hopefully someone else will enjoy them way more than I did. But yeah, let's just get started with this video and then I'm going to show you all the books that I'm going to get rid of. The first book that I'm going to unhaul is actually a book that I gave 5 stars, and that is One of Us is Lying by Karen M. McManus. So I read this book last year and at the time I thought it was a really good like YA thriller. I loved it, I really enjoyed reading it, but now that I look back at it I really don't know why I thought it was so good. Because in hindsight, I like forgot about this book very quickly. So yeah, this is a book that I think is very good at the moment that you're reading it, but then after that, it's just not that special anymore somehow. So I won't give it 5 stars anymore. I think it's actually more of a 3-star read. I mean, I still think it's very enjoyable because I did have a really good time reading it. But I'm not going to reread it or like keep it because it's not special to me. So that's why I think someone else will probably be way happier with this book than I am right now. So yeah, that is why this book is going away and I don't really want it anymore. Then I have this really weird edition of Les Misérables by Victor Hugo. Because this is like a weird film edition, but it's not the real book because the real book is way bigger than this. I read this book when the film came out and at the moment I really did not know that it wasn't like the real version because I'd never heard of the story before. But yeah, it's this weird adapted film version of the book, so I don't really want to have that anymore. I don't even know what it is exactly and how it is like edited and why they did this weird short version. But yeah, I don't think I'm ever going to read the real Les Misérables book because, as I said, that one is massive, really long, really big. But I also don't want to have this like random edition anymore. The next book I'm going to unhaul is What the Dead Know by Laura Lippman. And this is, as you can see, the Dutch edition, which is called Verdwenen Zusjes. This is a thriller. It's a very basic thriller. It's about these two sisters who disappear and then one sister shows up again. I mean, it's a fine thriller. There's nothing really wrong with it. It's fun. I like the plot twist in the end. But again, a book that it's not like special or amazing. So it's not really a book worth keeping for me. So that's why this book is going as well. I don't need to have it anymore and I'm never going to read it again. Then the next book that I'm going to unhaul pains me a little bit, but it is this Arc of Frostblood by Ellie Blake. This was in a fairy loot box a very long time ago. And I remember being all excited because it was an arc and like I'd never had an arc before. But the thing is, I'm just so not interested in the story. Like, Frostblood has been out for a while now. I believe the sequel is out as well. And I've had this book for more than 2 years. I still haven't picked it up. I've never felt any interest in reading it. And I feel a bit sad about this because I normally don't like unhauling books that I haven't read yet. But of course, this book I haven't picked myself. So yeah, I think this arc is going to go. I'm never going to read it. So yeah, I think it can better go and make space for more books. The next book I'm going to get rid of is The Shock of the Fall by Nathan Filler. The reason why I kept this book for so long is because I read it on a specific London trip and I always connect books to like certain places and certain memories. So that's why I did not want to get rid of it, even though I'm not like that impressed with the story. I think I read this like many years ago, way before I even discovered BookTube. And like the story is a mental health story, but now that I'm thinking back of it, it was very confusing and I really don't know what like the whole thing was about. That's what I remember about reading this, just being confused the entire time. And again, I guess the book was fine, but not like that good. I do like the cover and like I kept it because of the memory to like a London trip. But then on the other hand, I go to London many times. I read many books in London, so like this one maybe isn't that special. So yeah, this book is going away as well. The next book that I'm going to unhaul is The Weight of Feathers by Anna Marie McLemore. I was very underwhelmed by this book. It is a magical realism book and it is sort of inspired by Romeo and Juliet. I heard some very positive reviews about it because everyone seems to love Anna Marie McLemore. And yeah, I got this, I read this and I was just like, very much meh about it. The story felt weird to me and I just didn't really get it. I think there's something about this book that other people love, but I just didn't see what it was. It wasn't a horrible book, it was just a little bit disappointing. Especially since my expectations were so high, I thought it was like not that great. So yeah, again, I think it's time for this book to go. I'm also going to get rid of Looking for Alaska by John Green. In like a previous book unhaul, I got rid of a lot of John Green books, but I kept this one because I did sort of like it when I read it. It was like one of the better John Green books from like my massive collection. But it's also not that good or that important to me. The only John Green books that I'm keeping are The Fault in Our Stars, of course, because like that's almost a classic, and Turtles All the Way Down. But I decided that I could live without Looking for Alaska as well. Again, a book that is like okay, but I'm not like blown away by it or anything. Don't remember that much of the story, to be honest. So yeah, another John Green book that has to go. I'm not the biggest John Green fan. I'm like very specific with his books. I sometimes like them, sometimes don't. Then I have a book that I only got very recently, and that is the Wreck This Journal in the Dutch edition by Carrie Smith. I got this in my goodie bag of like Jalvest NL. But the thing is, this is not really a book that I really like. It's sort of like this creative book where you have to fill in certain things and do certain challenges. I went through it, but it's like way too like random and silly for me. I'm not that kind of person. It's just not my thing. So that's why it has to go. Like, I don't have space on my bookshelves left for a book that I'm never going to use, that I'm never going to fill in. Somebody else probably will. Then next I have a very popular book, and I actually have quite a few popular books on this list, and that is The Gentleman's Guide to Vice and Virtue by Mackenzie Lee. I know, people might be shocked because everyone seems to love this book. And again, this is a book that I read with very high expectations, and I was very underwhelmed. I mean, it's cute, it's funny. Sure, it's like an enjoyable book. It's definitely something different. But also, I just didn't really like it all that much. I mean, it was okay. It was fine, I guess. But I did not fall in love with this book as everyone else seemed to do. I just didn't really see it, what everyone else saw in this. And normally, if I had more space left on my bookshelves, I would keep this. But since I have to be hard because I have so many new books that I can't put anywhere anymore, this one has to go, I'm afraid. But then again, as with all these books, somebody else will probably be way more happy with it than I was. And then next I have All the Bright Places by Jennifer Niven. And this is another book that I really enjoyed, like, at the time that I was reading it. But that is also 2 years ago. Looking back at it, it's really not the best mental health book out of all of the mental health books that I've read. And I mean, this was one of the first mental health books that I read, so like, back then I thought it was really good. And now I think it's okay and like, but not that amazing. And this is another book that I really don't remember that much of. It's not like that special to me. And again, as I said before, I have to be tough. I have to like really get rid of some books. So yeah, All the Bright Places is going away, unfortunately. I enjoyed it when I read it, but I'm not going to reread it ever again. Then the next book that I'm also going to unhaul is 13 Reasons Why by Jay Asher. This book was just boring to me. I read it after I saw season one of the TV show. I actually liked the TV show because at least it had a little bit more like action, a little bit more stuff happening. The actual book takes place over one night. The story is a lot more simple and also, yeah, a lot more boring in my opinion. I don't think I would have ever bought this book if it wasn't for the TV show. And yeah, another book that was like, I guess, okay, but didn't really grab me all that much. Yeah, it's definitely not one of my favorite books. It's just, as I said, it's sort of boring. Not that much happens in this book. I mean, yeah, sure, some things happen, but like, it's not my thing. Oh, I still have so many more books to talk about. Like, this video is going to be so long. But anyway, next I have the Dutch edition of Us by David Nichols. And yeah, I'm just not a big David Nichols fan. I believe there are some people who are like obsessed with his books, but I've never really seen it. A year ago, I already got rid of One Day by David Nichols, which I thought was like actually just bad, like really not that good. And Us is sort of like enjoyable but also really weird. Like, the story is just very weird and I didn't really get it. I had an okay time reading this, but then again, I read this when I didn't know about BookTube and I didn't have like that many amazing book recommendations. So at the time it was okay, but like right now it's not that okay anymore. And again, I'm never going to read it again, so why should I keep it? So yeah, now I have two books that I've talked many times about before. But yeah, they are finally going away. And the first one out of those is Flame in the Mist by Renée Adier. Yeah, I did not like this book. I was very much disappointed by it. I've talked about it multiple times. Basically, I thought the main character wasn't that interesting. The story wasn't that interesting. It was all very forgettable. I just did not like Flame in the Mist. And I was actually really sad about that because I really wanted to love it. But unfortunately, I didn't. And the only reason why I've kept this book so long is because the cover is so gorgeous. And that's why I'm a little bit sad to get rid of it, because the cover is like so pretty. But yeah, as I mentioned before, I don't have space left on my bookshelves for books that I don't like, even though the cover is very beautiful. So yeah, it's finally time. It has to go. It wasn't that amazing. I'm sad about it, but yeah, it's going away. And yeah, the same story goes for Caraval by Stephanie Garber. Another book that I was very excited for, but then was very much disappointed with. It tried to be The Night Circus, but it was nothing like The Night Circus. I did not like this book whatsoever. But yeah, it's another book that I kept because of its cover. Because again, this cover, like, it's amazing. It's so pretty. And it's purely because of that reason that I kept it so long. And yeah, I think it's again time to say goodbye to this book. Even though it's so pretty, I did not like the story. So yeah, this was it with Caraval. I'm finally going to get rid of it. And the next I have Daughter of the Burning City by Amanda Foody. And like, this is, it's an enjoyable book. It's, I don't hate it. I have nothing against it. But I also don't have anything like really going for it. It's also a circus theme book. And in any case, it's a lot better than Caraval. But also, it's again a book that I just wasn't blown away by. I did like the story. I did sort of like the mystery. I just felt that like it was a little bit rushed at times and it didn't feel all that developed, like especially the world building. It was okay, but not like amazing. So yeah, this is sort of like the definition of an okay, fine book to me. But it's another one that I'm never going to read again, so there's just no point in keeping this for me. So yeah, now I have what is probably my most unpopular unhaul, because I'm unhauling a duology. And that is the This Savage Song duology by Victoria Schwab. This is a very popular duology, book series, whatever. A lot of people like really, really love this. Like really love this. And I thought it was just okay. I did sort of like the first book, This Savage Song. Like I was interested enough to pick up the second book. And it's also a bit weird for me because I do really, really love the A Darker Shades of Magic series by Victoria or V.E. Schwab. But I personally thought that this book series was just nothing compared to that one. It's another book series where I just didn't see what everyone else was seeing. The Savage Song was still okay. That was a 4-star read, but Our Dark Duet was really very much, this was like a 3-star read to me. Yeah, again, it's something I'm very underwhelmed by. And I wanted to love it, but I don't. So yeah, that's why they are going away, unfortunately. And as I said, I know a lot of people love this. I couldn't get out of this book series what other people could get out of it. And then finally, the last book in this book unhaul is I See You by Claire McIntosh. This is a thriller and I got it because I really loved I Let You Go. You can see a sticker here, I Let You Go by Claire McIntosh. But unfortunately, I See You wasn't as nearly as good as I Let You Go. It was just very much meh again, very much okay, but I wasn't very much invested into the story. A thriller is supposed to be exciting, it's supposed to be tense, but I didn't feel any of that whilst reading this. It was quite mediocre. And yeah, I do love this beautiful hardback, but I don't have space for it left on my shelves. There are definitely way better thrillers out there. This wasn't the one for me, so again, it's going away. This book is also going to be unhauled. So yeah, that was it for this massive book unhaul. It was very, very much necessary, but now I finally have some more space left on my shelves. And it does feel very refreshing to get rid of some books, even though some of these make me a little bit sad, but like, it's better in the end. And yeah, as I said, I will find a better home for all of these books. But yeah, this was it now for this video. And if you like this video, please go subscribe or maybe give it a thumbs up, because I would really appreciate that. If you want to follow me on any social media, I will leave links to that down below in the description box. And then hopefully I will see you again in my next video. Bye!